Okay. Right, let's finish up this painting part here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, one down, one and a half to go. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm doing good. How are you doing? Yeah, that's good. I've been streaming quite a bit this week trying to finish this one up. So, yeah, I'm glad you can make it tonight. How is your Saturday night going? Oh, nice. What are you working on right now? Okay, nice. Is that I'm painting with acrylic paint, but then the lines, the black lines you can see on here, were done with a wood burner. So a little bit of mixed media going on here. Oh, my headphones are about to die. That's too bad. Did you hear what medium I'm working in? Acrylic paint on wood. Some wood burning going on. Why do you like painting landscapes? I like painting landscapes. Just, I don't know, to create something. I find landscapes beautiful, and just to create my own version of them, I guess, to, have that that creation effect is pretty cool. What about you? Why do you like painting landscapes? I'd never seen anybody do anything quite like this before either. I saw an artist in Toronto, one that I follow. He uses wood burning and acrylic painting, but not in the same way. He does more with like a torch and a little bit with a wood burner, but doesn't create geometric shapes like quite like I do here. But he was the first one that I saw combine any type of wood burning and painting, and that kind of got me thinking. So that's what got me going on this. And yeah, I understand what you're saying by being inspired by your surroundings. I'm in Alberta, Canada, so just north of Montana, and so we've got the prairies and the Rocky Mountains, and yeah, it's just beautiful. And so that's where I get most of my inspiration for sure. Whereabouts on the East Coast? Do you live there? New Jersey, nice. I've only been to the airport in New Jersey and the one in Newark. It wasn't the most pleasant time just in that airport, but I'm sure the rest of New Jersey is nice. I'm sure you are. Yeah. I mean, we were just going through on a layover. One day I'd like to, be able to see more of that area. I don't think I asked what medium do you work in mainly? I don't necessarily go on photography trips, but just from from photographs of just from traveling around in the last few years, and then even photographs that my dad takes, or my uncle's a photographer as well. So I try to use my own if I can, and then if I can't, if I don't have something that I like, then I'll see what my dad's taken, see what my uncle's taken, and they let me use their photos. And then if there's really nothing that I'm liking, then I'll use the copyright free photo libraries you can find online. But most of these wood ones, yeah, almost all of them are from photos that I've taken myself. This one has kind of been a combo of a few. But yeah, like most of the lake ones are all photos I took myself, and I try to use my own as much as I can. Yeah, I know what you're talking about oils. I have never worked with them, but I'd be interested to try for sure, just for the blending. But yeah, that's one thing. I don't know how long it'll take, but I'd like to try it one day. What made me want to become an artist? Honestly, I don't know what it was. I was in university and I was trying to find something to do during those long, cold winter nights because I was studying up in Edmonton. It's just in central Alberta, but it's pretty north. And yeah, so I just decided to go pick up some cheap art supplies and followed a simple YouTube tutorial of painting and liked it and just kept on going from there. And it's been about 6 years now that I've been creating art. So yeah, what about you? Yeah, that's fair. Yeah. I think just the thrill of creating something. I don't know, especially when I do my wildlife paintings. You know, when you put in, for me, it's especially the eye. When I paint the eye, I save it for the end because then it really just brings the whole thing to life, and that moment is, I don't know, I just love it. And I think that's one thing that always has driven me to continue to create. Hey CF, glad you could join us. Yeah, I've got quite a bit done, almost just a little bit left here, and then that'll be it. I've been going for just over 2 hours now, trying to, I thought it would take less time tonight, but no, it's taking a little bit more. Yeah, definitely been zoning in hard the last few days. Yeah, I do varnish this stuff with a gloss covering, and so I'll be doing that. Hopefully tomorrow. Acrylic paint, it sets pretty quick on wood, and so if not tomorrow, then on Monday I'll be varnishing and sealing this one up. They were hoping to receive this one by Christmas, so I've been trying to, really work on it and get it done. Then I've got two other orders I need to fill as well, so we'll see how this week goes. Luckily, those other orders are on smaller ones, and so I've already started one of them, and then the other one doesn't have to arrive by Christmas, so I've got some more time with that one, which is nice. We've got a little bit of white left here. I'm just gonna double check, and you are in these clouds that need a little touch up with some extra white. In some spots where the wood burns darker from the wood burner, like around the lines, then it takes a few extra layers of white to make it not show through as much. The burning technique called pyrography. Pyrography. Hey, Kristen, thanks for joining. Yeah, it is kind of like a almost like a mosaic style, just with different mediums. Okay, where else do I need to touch up? Let's touch this guy up here as well. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's an interesting technique, that's for sure. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I love it. So I'm just using up this extra white that I had, then I'll finish off the roof on that elevator there, but I've got extra paint on the palette. I don't like to waste it if I don't have to. And then afterwards, once I get it all painted, then I take a blowtorch and I burn the edges all the way around and give it a black frame around it. All right, I think I'm gonna go in and finish up that, and then we'll do a last look over in a minute here. And hopefully be done the painting portion of this piece. Sorry, I've just got this white, and I keep on seeing a few little spots that could use just a little extra. Oh, you watched one of those videos. That's sweet. Yeah, I mean, I haven't burnt myself yet, so we're doing okay. Sometimes it gets a little bit hot, but overall, it's all right. What have you been up to today, CF? All right, I've got it. It's about 3/4 of an inch thick. And even the small ones I do are that same thickness, about 3/4 of an inch. If you match it up here, they match up. So I just buy boards and then I cut them myself. I use a saw here and these smaller ones that I do, I can get like 8 foot long boards, so I usually can get, I don't know, how many would I get? Seven or eight things out of them. But this one, I only ended up, because this is 20 by 30 right now, and when I bought it, it was 20 by 36, so I just cut off 6 inches. I wish I could find them, like already a nice, even cut, but that's not always the case. So yeah, I just cut them. Yeah, this one itself is it's pretty heavy. I'm interested to see how much it's going to be to ship it. I usually just pick up the boards at Home Depot. That's usually where I get them from. And I heard that they have a cutting service where they'll cut it for you, but I haven't tried that yet. I'm gonna have to try that one of these times, because for this one especially, I'd use a table saw, and then you're worried about it not coming out straight. And they've got big saws where it's easy for them to, make a straight cut. So. All right. Well, hey, sorry you kind of came at the end here, but I feel bad. But I'll probably take tomorrow off. I don't think I'll be streaming tomorrow, but I plan to stream later this week. I've got these two that where's the light here? Got these two that I'm working on now next for an order, so I'm gonna see if I can get these ones done in time to ship them for Christmas. The order was just made this past week, so I'll try my best. I got the skies done earlier today. I didn't stream that or anything, but I'll be streaming my work on these ones this week. So hopefully, if you want to tune into those ones, that would be awesome. It's usually always around that same time, 7:30 Mountain Standard Time. So for you, it'd be around 6:30, and I usually can go till 9 o'clock ish my time. So, right, well, thanks everyone for tuning in. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channel, but I know most of you have, and I appreciate that. And have a great rest of your weekend. And we will see you later.